Hi, welcome to part 3 in our series about making HTML5 games with RAID. So this one's going to be fun because we've covered most of the boring bits in the first two tutorials. So we've got this simple game going, four moles on the screen moving up and down. The goal of the game is to hit the moles as they come out of their holes to score points. So there are lots of things we can do to make this game better. I'd say that the biggest problem we've got is that they're all moving in the same way at the same time. So let's change that. In our main app file, awesome.js, let's add a member to our app function called moles, which is an empty array initially. These square brackets indicate an empty array. Then as we create our moles, we add them to our array like this. This moles push mole. So now this moles array contains all of our mole objects. Now let's go to our mole behavior file, mole.js. And for convenience, I'm going to add a couple more functions to this behaviour to move the mole up and down. This goUp equals function. And here we can move the mole up, copying and pasting this line of code up here with the moveTo function call. And we do the same for this goDown. Actually, we want to change the state of the mole inside these go up and go down functions, so I'll move this code here. Now we might as well use these new functions by replacing these long lines of code with calls to go up and go down. It's important to note that because go up and go down are member functions of the mole behavior, they are going to be accessible from outside this file. And that's precisely what we're going to do in a moment. But first, I want to get rid of this goUp in the onAddToScene function, which is telling the mole to start moving as soon as it's added to the scene. We don't want that. What we want instead is to change the position of the mole as soon as it's added to the scene, so that it's completely hidden. This owner setPosition, this original position X, this original position Y plus 50. Now, in awesome.js, after creating all of the moles, we pick the first one and tell it to start moving up like this. This mole's 0, get behavior, go up. Now, let's have a quick look in Chrome. When we refresh the page, the first mole in the top left hole starts moving up while the others stay hidden. This is a step in the right direction, but still our mole's moving continuously, and we don't want that. We can see why that's happening by looking at the mole behaviour, specifically the onMoveComplete function. Here we're telling the moles to start moving again as soon as they've finished moving. So in fact, when the mole has just come up, that is the correct behaviour. We do want it to go down again straight away. But what we don't really like is that it comes back up again as soon as it's gone down. What we want is another mole to do this. So let's pick a random mole. I'm going to generate a random number between 0 and the number of moles we have in our game, like this. Var random mole equals math.random times weighed app moles length. This works because math.random generates a number between 0 and 1. If I multiply it by the number of our moles, that's the length of the moles array, in this case 4. I have a random number between 0 and 4. And then I take the integer part of this number using math.floor. Now, instead of saying this go up, I can say weighed app moles random mole, get behavior, go up. Let's see what happens in Chrome. Now, as soon as our mole goes down, a random one goes up. It's starting to look like an interesting game now, but it's still a bit too simple, mainly because of the movement speed of our moles, but that's easy to change. In awesome.js, let's add a member to our app function called speed that is initially 100. Then in mole.js, when we move up and down, we use this value, weighed app speed. And right before choosing a new mole to move up, right here, we increase that speed by 10, for example. Then you can tweak these numbers until you're happy that it feels challenging enough but not too difficult. So if we go to Chrome again and refresh and leave it running for a while, the speed will keep increasing until it gets really quite challenging to catch these moles. In fact, we might also want to cap the speed so it doesn't ever get larger than 500, for example. Weighed app speed equals math min weighed app speed 500. Now there's another quick improvement that we can make, or we should add more of these moles to the scene. Four's not nearly enough. But how are we going to do it? I mean, given the size of the moles, we can hardly fit more than four on an average size screen. So we could change the size of our sprites, but there's actually a much easier way. Wade has some interesting ways of dealing with screens that have different sizes and aspect ratios, but that's something we're going to be looking at in the next part of video tutorials. What we're going to do today is a little bit more simple. We're simply going to move the camera. You see, in Wade, you're always looking at the scene through a camera. Now, for example, if you have a mole that's 300 units big, it doesn't necessarily mean that it's 300 pixels big as well. Or rather, one unit does equal one pixel until, of course, you move the camera to zoom in or out, which we can do very easily. The camera has three coordinates, X, Y, and Z, Z being the distance from the screen, and it's initially set to 1. Now let's try this in awesome.js. Wade, set camera position, X 0, Y 0, Z 2. So we're still looking at the origin 0, 0, but we're moving back a little. Let's see what it's looking like. It's exactly as we expected. Everything's smaller. That's pretty much what we wanted, but not quite. We didn't want our score text to get smaller too. Somehow, we have to say that we don't want the size of our score text to be affected by camera movements. But that's not such a big deal. When we create our score text sprite in awesome.js, we simply have to put it in its own layer. Say, for example, layer 3. And then we tell Wade that we don't want objects on layer 3 to scale up or down when the camera moves, like this. Wade, set layer transform, 3, 0, 0. There are three numbers here. The first one is the layer number, in this case layer 3. The second number indicates how much objects on layer 3 should be scaled up or down when the camera zooms in and out. By setting it to 0, we're saying that we don't want any scaling. The third number indicates how much objects should move on X and Y when the camera pans on X and Y. By setting it to 0, we're saying we want no movement at all. In other words, no matter what the camera does, objects on layer 3 are not going to move. These scale and translation factors are 1 by default, but you can set them to anything you like, for example 0.5, to achieve a variety of interesting effects, such as parallax effect. Okay, we can now change our grid size to 4 and have lots of objects on the screen, so let's go ahead and do it. And now let's look at it in Chrome. Okay, this is much better. One last thing, we need a background image here. I'm going to look for a random picture of grass on Google. Obviously it's going to be copyrighted, so don't do this if you're making a proper commercial game. But for the purpose of this tutorial, we'll get one like this. I'll save it into my awesome game folder and call it grass.jpg. Now in awesome.js, in the init function, I'm going to create a background scene object that contains a sprite with this grass picture. And I'll make sure to place it behind everything else on layer 30. Wade, add scene object, this background. Oh, and of course I need to load this picture in the load function here. And there we go. So we've definitely made some progress with our game, but there's still work to do. In the next tutorial, we're going to be putting a bit of eye candy in, some animations and particle effects. And I'm also going to be showing you how you can really easily deal with different screen sizes and aspect ratios, so keep following us. Thanks for watching. See you soon.